is made up of 17 autonomous communities, each of them with its own culture, traditions, and even language. Since 2010, the pro-independence movement intensified, especially in Catalonia, where on October the 1st of 2017, a self-determination referendum was held. It was later declared illegal by the central Spanish government. Consequently, the region's autonomy was suspended, and many politicians were called to testify in court. Some of them were taken into custody while awaiting the trial.
I'm Martí. I'm from Catalonia and currently living in Madrid. For me, it has been complicated to start this new chapter in Madrid with the outbreak of such a situation. My first 3 months in this city. My first 3 months in this city were extremely tough. In the residence where I live, I was treated badly just because I was Catalan. I was the only one out of 150 residents. What hurt me the most was that also in the group of Youth for a United World, which I see often, we were constantly arguing and getting angry with each other.
You,
due to our opposing points of view. Knowing that we couldn't go ahead like this, we decided to sit down and started discussing sincerely, trying to listen to one another and putting aside our differences. Feeling respected and valued allowed us to get beyond those barriers.
Hola, soy l'Alba de Barcelona. Crec que estar aquí junts parlant amb gent que pensa de manera molt diferent a mi ja és un èxit del que significa la unitat. Tot i que aquesta situació ha generat molt de dolor social i personal, també m'ha donat la possibilitat de passar per experiències que m'han fet aprendre i créixer com a persona. Quan es va fer el referèndum de Catalunya i es va desencadenar la violència de la policia, alguns dels Joves per un Món Unit catalans i jo eren presents allà. En aquell moment vaig sentir una barreja de sentiments, felicitat, orgull i llibertat com a nació, però al mateix temps por, ràbia i tristesa. Degut a la meva indignació, vaig tenir molta activitat a les xarxes socials. Molts dels comentaris dels altres Joves per un Món Unit em ferien profundament, però no m'havia parat a pensar que els meus comentaris també podien ferir els altres. En aquests dies hi havia un congrés a Madrid i ens van convidar a compartir les nostres experiències i pensaments sobre la situació política. No em vaig sentir amb forces de parlar, ja que les ferides no estaven tancades. L'únic que em va venir de dins va ser perdó i gràcies. Després, aquell mateix dia, una d'elles es va apropar per parlar amb més profunditat. Al principi va ser molt difícil, perquè cap de les dues sabia com afrontar el tema sense ferir l'altra. Va ser llavors quan em va proposar de posar l'amor en primer lloc. Em va sorprendre molt, començant i acabant en l'amor. Realment vam parlar des de la mateixa posició, preocupant-nos pel que l'altre havia de dir, més que per defensar la pròpia idea. Em vaig adonar que la persona és molt més important que la seva opinió. Des d'aquell moment, continuem treballant i les nostres opinions no han canviat. Això fa que sigui complicat i de vegades se'ns oblida i hem de començar de nou perquè tenim idees fortes. Però la incomprensió que sorgeix d'aquest dolor, al final, esdevé quelcom pur i amb més valor.
My name is Laura. I am Spanish and I feel profoundly identified with my country roots. In the days close to the 1st of October, I was feeling sad for everything was happening. I didn't understand, well, why there were people that wanted to separate from Spain. Although I knew I had to make an effort to be empathic and try to understand them, but it wasn't easy. Furthermore, mass media were all over it, and it was hard for me to understand where the truth was. Most of all, was hurting to see there was any wild for dialogue. At that point, I saw on social network a call of action for peace and dialogue, to which we were invited to participate with no flags. Its purpose was simply for the politicians to sit down and discuss. I feel completely identified with this idea. I invite some friends in my WhatsApp chats. To my surprise, such an invitation didn't get a good reception. The day of the demonstration, in which I took part with some friends, there were very diverse people. We were in Madrid, only a few meters away from the square where another demonstration was taking place. Its color, red. Its flag, the Spanish one. I experienced a deep pain since I love my colors and I love my flag. At that moment, I felt that flag was only dividing us farther apart. When I post a photo dressed in white on social networks, I got many posts with various and not positive remarks. My friends and I thought that the real change had to start within our circle. I remember my previous proposal on WhatsApp and all the negative feedbacks. If I really wish to promote dialogue, I had to start from there. Therefore, I proposed to have a coffee with whoever wanted. Thereby, a space for conversation was open, and still today, everyone can express what they feel without being judged. Bringing our ideas together and looking for shared solutions.
To our mind, it's still an unfinished road. We keep paving the way day in, day out, with uncertainties and pain, but also enriched by the different experiences we've shared. Because of that, we are convinced that we have to intensify them and increase the amount of spaces of dialogue, showing that the path towards fraternity starts there. This goes even beyond dialogue, it's about building a united wall